Yes, record session started. Today concept of terminology. Next term benchmark. Next term 26th term benchmark. Benchmark means, so recently we completed one project. The project name is ICIC Bank project. So successfully we completed. So this is very highlighted project, very important project. We successfully we completed. So that is the reason we can say it is a defined as the standard. Benchmark means it is a stand. It is a defined as the standard in which usually we compared. So we can compare if you get in future any project, we can compare with the ICIC Bank project. So just like that is the benchmark. So that means it is 100% a successful project. So that's the reason we are comparing always. So that is called benchmark. Benchmark means it is defined as the standard it which usually we compared. It which usually we compared. So that is called benchmark. Simple. It's very easy term. Next, change request.
Okay.
So first of all, customer, he will give FRS. FRS means he will mention the all the customer requirements. So after mentioning the customer requirements, based on the customer requirements, developers will develop the application. So okay, but middle of the project, customer, if he want to change any requirements, so you need to fill the change request template. Change request means it is a process of requesting the changes by the customers to the company to do the same. Usually the customer use change request to document. So compulsory you need to fill the change request to document or change request to template. So why? Because already he gave requirements and middle of the project and he want to change some requirements. So that is the reason he need to fill the change request to template and he need to change the requirement. He want to change the requirements. That time he should fill the change request to template. Then only software company will be accept. Otherwise it will not accept. So compulsory he should follow one template, that is called change request to template. And impact analysis. Impact analysis. After giving the change request, the company people will analyze, is it possible or not? So if it is possible, they will accept, otherwise they will not accept. So in fact, analysis means it is a process of analysis, how much impact will fall on the already developed part, if at all accept those new changes at that point of time. So if it is already developed, so they will not accept. So if it is not developed, they will accept. So that is called impact analysis. So if they accept the requirements, how much impact already developed application, so they will analyze. So if it is there is no impact already developed part, so then they will accept, otherwise they will reject. So that is impact analysis. And next, test suite. Test suite is nothing but it is a combination of number of test cases or all test cases. That is called test suite. Some companies they are saying, so it is a combination of regression test cases and retest cases. Regression plus retest cases. Regression plus retest cases. It is a combination of regression and retest cases. So, or simple we can say it is a combination of number of test cases is called test suite. Test suite is nothing but it is a combination of regression test cases and retest cases, or it is a combination of multiple test cases. That is called test suite. Next, test bed. Test bed is nothing but it is a combination of test suite and test environment. Test suite plus test environment. That is called test bed. It is a combination of test suite and test environment. Okay. Test suite means number of test cases. Test environment means customer specified environment. Like customer is said the developed project should work in Windows 7 environment. That is the Windows 7 is the test environment. So test bed. First of all, test bed means we need to execute all the test cases. Where exactly we need to execute based on the customer requirement. Customer is said Windows 7 environment. That is called test environment. So that environment is called test bed. Next. Defect age. Defect age means just defect age. The time gap between opening date and closing date of the defect. That is called defect age. Finding gap between opening date or finding the defect date and closing the defect date. In between gap is called defect age. Defect age. Defect age is the time gap between the opening date and the closing date of the defect. Next, walkthroughs. Walkthrough. Each and every software company, Friday or Monday, they will conduct walkthroughs. Walkthrough means it is an informal meeting. So in this meeting, all the project people will be participating in this meeting, or team members will be participating in this meeting. They will discuss about this particular project. They will share the knowledge. They will share the knowledge. So that is the reason each and every software company for weekend or first day of week or Monday or Friday. So they will conduct walkthroughs. Walkthroughs is nothing but it is defined as informal meeting conducted with the roles either transfer the knowledge or check something. So just they will transfer the knowledge. So they will give some ideas. So they will transfer the their ideas. So that is called walkthrough. Walkthrough means it is a informal meeting. Right. Next, code walkthrough. Code walkthrough. Code walkthrough. Code walkthrough means, so code walkthrough, this is the development people will use this word code walkthrough. So actually, so while developing the application, they will follow coding standards. If they follow coding standards, application performance is very good. If they are not following coding standards, application performance is very slow. So while developing the application, they should follow the coding standards. So code walkthrough means it is a process of checking conducted on the source code. Source code means that is the code. Source code means that is the code. Developers, they will write the code. So that is called source code. They will checking conducted on the source code in order to confirm whether it is developed according to the coding standards or not. So that is called code walkthrough. If they follow coding standards, application performance is very good. So that is code walkthrough. Next, next term is related term. Code optimization. Or fine tuning. Code optimization or fine tuning. Code optimization or fine tuning. Okay. Next term, code optimization or fine tuning. It is a process of reading the number of lines of the code complexity. So they will check code complexity. If it is code complexity is very good, then application performance is very good. So if it is code complexity is not very good, so application performance is very slow. So code optimization, code is correct or not, they followed coding standards or not, they will check once again. So that is called code optimization or fine tuning. In previous, in past, some 10 years back or 15 years back, in our homes we have TV like tuning. So if you do tune, that picture will come clearly. Otherwise, picture is shaking, something disturbances will come. So that is called fine tuning. They are checking the code. Once again, they are checking the code complexity. They are checking if it is code is very complexity. So application performance is very good. and PPM. PPM. Periodic project meeting. Periodic project meeting. PPM means periodic project meeting. It is a meeting conducted periodically. In this meeting, only this particular project people will be participate in this meeting. Team lead and testers, developers, all the people will be participate in this meeting. So that is called PPM, periodic project meeting. In this meeting, they will discuss some points. They will discuss some points. How much percentage covered in this, during this time or during this period? How much percentage not covered during this period? And task completed during this period, and total defects, slippages, already I told you, if you want to complete a particular task, if you take any extra time, that is called slippage, extra time to complete a particular task, that is called slippage. So reasons for slippages and technical issues, HR related issues, they will discuss in this meeting. Only this particular project people only will be participate in this meeting. So that is periodic project meeting. It is a meeting conducted periodically. In this meeting, only that particular project belong people only will be participate. And in this meeting, they will discuss how much percentage covered during this period, how much percentage not covered during this period, and task completed during this period, and total defects and slippages and reasons for slippages, technical issues and HR related issues, they will discuss in this meeting. Before conduct PPM, they will send PPR. PPR. PPR means periodic project report. Periodic project report. So it is a report prepared by the team lead, and they will send it to members of the particular project. So, PPR, right. So, this is the one of the report prepared by team lead. He will send it to what are the points they want to discuss. He will list out and he will send it to all the members of the project. That is called PPR, periodic project report. It is a report prepared by team lead, and he will send it to members of the project. So what are the points they want to discuss in this meeting? He will intimate to members. That is called PPR, periodic project report. Next term, MOM, minutes of meeting. MOM means minutes of meeting. So MOM is the output document, outcome document or output document of any meeting. So, which contains the list of all the important points they discuss in the meeting. So, MOM is the output document or outcome document. So, of any meeting. So, which contains the list of important points discussed during that meeting. So, that is called MOM, minutes of meeting. Next term, MRM, management representation meeting. MRM, management representation meeting. It is a total company people, total high level authorities will be participate in this meeting. That is MRM, management representation meeting. It is a meeting conducted in the software company. So high level management people will be participate. So total high level management people only. Not only project. PPM is only particular project people. So MRM means management representation meeting. So only management people will be participate in this meeting. So in this meeting, they will discuss the success rate, growth rate of the company, total status of the company they will discuss. So in this main meeting, they will discuss about success rate, growth rate of the company, projects recently signed off, okay, and what are the projects currently running and upcoming projects, future plans, customer appraisals, customer negative comments, customer positive comments, future plans and internal audit reports, everything they will discuss in this meeting. That is MRM, management representation meeting. Last term, patch. So after finding the defect, we will raise the defect to developers. Then developers, they will rectify and they will sending to testing department. So that means, so already developed, so some defects is there, that's the reason we raised the defect to developers. Then they will rectify and once again they will sending to testing department. So that is called patch. So why? Because we are calling patch, they will not develop new application. So already developed application, they will do some changes. So that's why that is called patch. Patch. Okay. Next definition, traceability matrix. Traceability matrix. Very, very important definition. So that's the reason I'm teaching last. Traceability matrix. So I'm writing the definition also. Traceability matrix. What do you mean by traceability matrix? Traceability matrix is nothing but it is a document. Which contains some table of linking information. Which is used for tracing back for the reference whenever there is a back for the reference whenever there is a questionable situation. Traceability matrix is nothing but it is a document which contains some table of linking information which is used for tracing back for the reference whenever there is a questionable situation. That is called traceability matrix. So we can trace back for the reference. We can trace back for the reference whenever there is a questionable situation. With example, I will show you. No, very, very important definition. Very, very important. So first, based on FRS, we will write use cases. First, FRS document. Based on FRS, we will write use cases. US. US means, sorry, UC. Use cases. Based on use cases, we will write to test cases, TC. So, already we wrote some test cases. In these test cases, we will short out or shortlist very important test cases. That is called DTC, detailed test cases. In the detailed test cases, once again, we will shortlist and we will prepare master test cases, MTC. If you execute, we can get defects. Okay. First, we have four requirements, for example. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have four requirements. Okay. Based on only single requirement, we are writing three use cases. 1, 2, 3. Based on one use case, we are writing four test cases. Four test cases. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. We are writing four test cases. So, if it is customer is giving 30 days, they will execute this all test cases. If they give 20 days, they will execute only detailed test cases. If they give only 10 days, they will execute only master test cases. So here is very, very important test cases. They will list out here one important and three important and four important. Very, very important. Only important. And here one is very, very important. Four is very, very important. This is the master test cases. Once again, they will shortlist and they will prepare master test cases. So if they execute first requirement, first master test case, they got one defect. So then we can trace back for the reference from which requirement we got the defect. We can trace back for the reference. So from which requirement we got the defect, we can find out using traceability matrix. Okay, from first requirement we got the defect. So traceability matrix is nothing but it is a trace back for the reference whenever there is a questionable situation. If you have doubt, like from which requirement we got the defect, we can find out using this traceability matrix. That is the one use. Second use is all the requirements covered or not, we can find out using traceability matrix. Okay, all the requirements covered or not. If it is mapping is there, yes, covered. If it is there is no mapping, it is not covered. So 2, 3, 4 not covered. Only one requirement, first requirement is covered, 2, 3, 4 not covered. So that's why we can say traceability matrix is very, very important. Whenever you are facing the interview also, that time they may ask you like how much percentage project is completed, how you know. So using traceability matrix only. So our total, this project having 4 requirements, for example, one requirement covered, that means 25% is covered. If it is 2 requirements covered, so 50% is covered. 3 requirements covered, 75% is covered. If it is 4 requirements covered, that means total complete covered, all the project covered. So using traceability matrix, we have 2 uses. One is from which requirement we got the defect, and all the requirements covered or not, we can find out using traceability matrix. This is the very, very important definition in entire manual testing. Test design techniques and traceability matrix, both are very, very important. And last one, test scenario. Test scenario. Scenario means situation. Scenario means situation. So we have an application. We have some fields, username, password, sign in, last term, over. So this is the one scenario. Scenario is we need to click on login button. That is the scenario. We need to click on sign in button. That is the scenario. So we will write 4 test cases for this scenario. First, we will take write username, write password. We will click on sign in button. This is one test case. Write username, wrong password. Wrong password, we will click on sign in button.
Sign in.
This is one test case. Wrong username.
Right password.
Wrong username, right password.
Sign in.
Password, we will click on sign in button. This is one scenario. Test case.
Wrong username, wrong password.
Click on sign in button. That is the 4th test case. So scenario means based on the scenario, we will write the test cases. Each and every scenario we need to identify. After getting the application, so first of all, we need to identify the scenarios. Based on the scenarios, we will prepare the test cases. So test scenario means situation. So based on the situation, we will prepare the test cases. Okay. This is a manual terminology. Manual terminology over. Tomorrow morning, once again, we have class India time 7:30. You can complete tomorrow only.